Big life, big stage, big lights, big Bobcats against the big Boilers from the Big Ten. I'm Russ Eisenstein, the voice of the Ohio Bobcats. Welcome to our Week 2 preview presented by the Athens County Convention and Visitors Bureau. It's a 1-0 Bobcats against the 0-1 Purdue University Boilermakers from Ross-8 Stadium in West Lafayette, Indiana on Friday night. Games for MAC schools against teams from the Big Ten are always big for a lot of reasons. This is the eighth game for a Frank Solich-led Cat crew against schools from that league, and Ohio's looking for the third win. The first one was back in 2006 against Illinois. The second, the shocker, against Penn State in the opener in 2012. The last time we saw a school from the Big Ten, well, that was back in 2015. Ohio lost a heartbreaker 27-24 to Minnesota. This is the eighth all-time meeting between these two schools. We haven't seen Purdue since 1988. Ohio's looking for the first victory in the series. This was already going to be a good matchup, but after the openers, well, it's even more interesting. Ohio with the biggest margin of victory in 80 years, 59-0 over Hampton in the opener. And Purdue, well, they took the 16th-ranked team Louisville down to the wire in the Circle City of Indianapolis.
It was a loss, but there were a whole lot of positive points for Purdue against 16th-ranked Louisville in Indianapolis on Saturday night. The start of the Jeff Brohm era started off with an early lead, and then a halftime advantage, 14-10, on a David Blau to Richie Worship connection. Blau had 25 touchdowns and 21 interceptions last year. The TDs in the opener were important, and the turnovers were too. A 61-yard pick six gave the Cards control at the end of three, 25-21. The Boilers were back on top, 28-25, when Elijah Sindelar found Jackson Anthrop. It was their second hookup of the night. Sindelar is a former Mr. Football in Kentucky and Gatorade All-American. He played sparingly last year, but will platoon with Blau this season. Ultimately, last year's Heisman Trophy winner made plays at the end. Cardinal quarterback Lamar Jackson had just under 500 yards of total offense on the night. Purdue's last prayer came up unanswered, and an interception sealed it, 35-28 the final. Yes, it was a loss, but it turned some heads, and the combination of that game, what Ohio did in the opener, Friday night in West Lafayette under permanent lights at Ross-8 Stadium, an FS1 TV audience, and two solid radio networks with the call, Bobcat head coach Frank Solich knows it will be a heck of an atmosphere.
It'll be a great atmosphere, and I think it's great exposure for our football team. I think it's great exposure for our football program. I think it's great exposure for Ohio University.
Purdue's a program that has been prominent in the past. They've had some quarterbacks there. Bob Greasy, Kyle Orton, and of course, Drew Brees, who still holds the school in Big Ten records for passing attempts, completions, yards, and touchdowns. But the last 4 years, the train was derailed. Just 9 wins under former Kent State head coach Daryl Hazel. Brohm won 30 games in 3 years, had 2 Conference USA titles, and 2 bowl wins at Western Kentucky. A new offensive style will put more coal in the engine. Purdue averaged 25 points and 390 yards per game last year. They gave up 38 and 445 on average. The Boilers' top 4 pass catchers are gone from last year, so Anthrop could be the top target this year. The running game averaged just 96 yards per contest last season, but DJ Knox is back after an ACL injury, so he could be a bulldog as sort of running back. The linebacking core is solid. Jawan Bentley had 10 tackles against the Cards, and Marcus Bailey has all Big Ten potential. As for turnovers, the Boilermakers were minus 17 and dead last in the country last year. Ohio was plus 1 and plus 1 against Hampton. Purdue was picked tied for last in the West with Illinois in the Big Ten preseason poll.
It is worth noting the playing surface, natural grass. In this day and age of college football, you could go years without playing on the real stuff. You could count the games that Ohio's played on grass basically on one hand over the last couple of seasons. The last time was actually last year. Ohio played hard but lost to Tennessee. We encourage you to make the trip. Really, West Lafayette is not that far from Athens or Columbus or a lot of portions of Bobcat Nation. There are a lot of alums in the Chicagoland area that can make the trip down I-65. I've been there many times as a fan, passed through there about 100 times going back home to Illinois from Athens over the years. It is a good drive, it is a good area, but I give you a word of caution. I-65, particularly in Tippecanoe County, is under constant construction. So build in some extra time as you get over to their very nice stadium. You bang the drum and say hello to Purdue Pete. But if you can't make the trip, we'll have it for you on the Ohio IMG Sports Network. Rob Cornelius, Ryan Boyd, and I will make up a three-man booth with Alex Birch back in our IMG studios. The game's also on FS1. All right, we've got you set. Ohio and Purdue under those Friday night lights in Indiana. For Jason Schapino, I'm Russ Eisenstein. Our game week preview is presented by the Athens County Convention and Visitors Bureau on the web at athensohio.com. And this is Bobcat TV.